live from Philadelphia. It's Single on a Saturday Night.
Single on a Saturday Night, a TV show that features intriguing conversations about music, cooking, celebrities, and more.
Listen, you can be married, you can be in a relationship situation. This show is just about relationships and everything that is going on in this world. So don't be afraid of the word single. It's still good, you know what I'm saying?
Welcome, welcome, everyone. We are back, Single on Saturday Night. 10 years, can you believe that we are back? Rolling with Shelly Shell, Roberto, Chatty Hattie joined us. The great Stormy's in the building. And, of course, my girl Nikki is here. But, ladies and gentlemen, we have done so many topics over the past 10 years. Today, we want to introduce something new.
What?
The topic today, y'all want
to
know?
I don't know. I was dying.
Talk to him, brother. Talk to him, brother. Talk to him, brother.
We went through thousands of things, and we figured out hurt people hurt people.
Ooh.
Indeed. Let's talk about it.
I want you to process that. What does it mean when we talk about hurt people hurt people? Who want to take that first? Anybody want to take that first? Want to think about it?
Let's talk about it.
Oh, I thought you were going first. You put the microphone
on.
No,
well, we can talk about it, but you know, sometimes, you know, you don't want to get too heavy too soon. But that's actually, Brother D, that's a thing that we talk about quite regularly, especially in our community, because when we go to deal with women and get into new relationships, or even trying to get out of a relationship and managing how you go to move, depending on who you're dealing with, depends on the reaction that you get. Because if you're dealing with a broken person that hasn't mended and dealt with those issues, it's going to come back to you. You could have been a person that kind of got over some of your longings and some of the things that was going on, and you might be better off for it because you understand a little better, but you might be dealing with somebody on the other side that's just not as in tune with healing themselves or being healed.
Because I know there are people that are hurt that don't realize that they're hurting other people. You can hurt me by not allowing me to get to know you better. You can hurt me from not giving me an opportunity and be fair to me. And that's what I worry about when it comes to hurt people hurting other people. It's a reality. I'm not that man who did that to you. I do not want to serve, Chatty, I don't want to serve another man's sentence. Be fair to me. Allow me the opportunity. Don't say all of a sudden, well, since he did this to me, from now on, every man I'm going to do blah, 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 blah. And that's not fair.
But you know what? It may not be conscious. It may not be a conscious thing. It may be something that you've already put the wall up, and it's not like, oh, when I meet this person. But you're inherently going to go back to some of the things that you thought. Like, if it seems familiar, like, yo, I remember when they did this. So then you're going to put that wall up and say, oh, that's what they did to me. So I'm automatically going to think that person's going to do it to me. And it's not like I said, you know, you might not set out to do it, but you're going to realize some things that people do are alike. And if that person hurt you, I'm like, oh, they just like that person because they did that to me. So then you're going to be putting your gloves up and the wall's going to be up and it's going to be on.
But they talk about, did they get to forgiveness yet? And I'm explaining, most people don't know what forgiveness looks like. Anybody know what it looks like? I'm about to tell you exactly what it looks like.
Trust me, brother, because I had to forgive myself first.
But here's another part of forgiveness.
But wait a minute, it's most a step before forgiveness. That's that healing. See, most people get hurt and they want to jump from one situation to the next situation before they're healed. And think about it. We can think about a physical heal. If you break your arm and your arm has not healed and you go out there to play basketball, it's not going to work. So sometimes we forget the value of healing. Physically, mentally, spiritually, emotionally before we go back out.
I just feel like a lot of us don't even know who we are as individuals. We don't even give us their self-love. So we trying to go out into the universe and love on other people or just give this attention, but we don't even know how to love ourselves. So it starts off with loving yourself so you can then be able to love other people.
All I know, in my situation and most folks that know me, break my arm, I'm going to break yours back.
That's the reality.
You're right. Hurt people.
When I talked about the forgiveness, there's only three words that you got to remember. Is can you remember without pain? That's when you know you have arrived at forgiveness.
Right.
Can you remember that situation without pain.
Wait. Hold up. I cannot believe that I can forgive someone. I cannot believe. And everyone knows about the situation that I had that I met someone here. I can forgive you, but the pain of something you did to me doesn't mean it's going to still hurt. Like, oh, I'm going to remember that you cut me. I'm going to remember that you stabbed me in my leg. I remember. Ooh.
But can you remember without
Shelley,
the pain?
After being in a relationship for 30 years, there have been things that my husband has done to me that hurt me, that took me about 9 to 10 years that don't hurt me anymore. But I had to be in it for 9 to 10 years before it didn't hurt.
Right, so he can't say forgiveness. It can't be forgiveness.
Pain, but you can remember it, but
I can remember it now without the pain.
10 years later.
Process.
Okay, I'm going to let it process.
Without pain.
No, because you made the statement earlier. You said if I'm in something, right, and for what happened to you, because, again, there's an effect, there's a ripple effect from that, because that situation didn't only just hurt you. It hurt the people that loved you and was close to you, too. And guess what? Everybody at some point had to let it go. And what it was for me was when I said, okay, she's operating in a more peaceful place, because that's the part of healing that we were talking about. You have to find that place and get through whatever it is in your healing process and get to that point. Not that you don't ever remember it, but it can't affect you the same way after such a period of time. And for Nikki, it was 9 to 10 years. For you, you might still be in that place of remembering it, that it bothers you. But are you at that place where it bothers you so much that you can't have a conversation with somebody that might be interested or talk about the situation and now be able to reflect on it to help somebody else, rather than saying, oh, don't be with a man that... No, because everybody's experience isn't yours. Everybody's experience isn't yours. Everybody's experience wasn't mine, because I had to forgive me first, because I could carry a grudge. You hurt me, break my heart, hurt my feelings. You're going to get broke back. But we had to find that place of better healing within.
Where if it doesn't kill you, it makes you stronger.
That was deep. That was real deep, Roberto. I like what you said there.
A blind squirrel can find a nut.
And how many of us here on the panel will be honest and say, I've been hurt and I've hurt other people?
Guilty.
Now, what have we done about it to change that process?
Whew. Somebody else?
Chatty Hattie.
Myself, the first thing we have to do is acknowledge it. Because a lot of times, may not be able to change our feelings, but we definitely can change our behavior. So just by telling someone, I know what you did, and I'm upset, but I'm sorry, I may not have done that, but maybe right now we don't need to be talking, but I'm sorry.
For me, my technique is, if I said something, and we talked about this a lot last year, because I was at a place with some people that I really, truly love, but we were just at a place where we weren't even talking to each other, and this was a friend. I did something that hurt you. I apologize for that. If you can't forgive me, I understand, but I had to forgive myself and put it out there to let you know that I'm not carrying that anymore. If we can reestablish our friendship, it doesn't have to be romantic, it don't have to be all those other things that it turned into, because that changed who we were. If I'm gonna forgive myself for what I did, I hope that you can forgive me. I acknowledge it and I apologize for it, and eventually be able to move forward. And since I've been able to do that, I'm so sorry. I can kick these 14s back and just look at everybody with a smile and say, I'm good, because I had to let it go. And once I let it go, that was a burden off me. Forgiveness was for me. And once I was able to acknowledge it and express my apologies for my actions, then eventually those people came around.
I play like I don't remember. I don't remember.
That's bad accountability.
I just played like I don't remember.
That's poor accountability, though.
That's what I'm is, though.
He's like, I'm just basically unaccountable.
Yeah, that's what I'm is.
Well, I'm very open, so however I'm feeling, if somebody is hurting me or any type of way, I'm going to express my feelings and let them know. But I have witnessed myself intentionally hurting someone because they had hurt me, but I admitted to it, so I can acknowledge my wrong. But I had to remove myself from the relationship because I knew that was like a trigger. It wasn't something that I was supposed to be in, because the person's supposed to love on you, and nobody's supposed to be pulling out these triggers of you and making you mad and doing other things. So, like, Yeah, just acknowledging and understanding, but just know that it's going to still be triggers. You want to get, like, different situations, whereas you want to experience some of the same things, but you got to learn how to control your emotions. It comes down to learn how to control your emotions, and once you know how to control your emotions, then you'll be able to learn how to navigate and not be able to react, you know, to every single thing.
Look, it's funny how you say control your emotions, because how does one learn to control their emotions? You be put in situations where you have to flex those muscles.
You have to flex those muscles. You have to face it. And you got to realize that it's a lesson out of everything that you go through. So don't look at it as, oh, it's something that's like going against you or anything like that. It's something that you need to learn so you can be able to grow within yourself. Like, all of these are growing pains. So at the end of the day, it's just like these are life lessons that we have to like learn on our own or together.
But I also think I'm still going to go back to, I don't know, I'm going to take responsibility for my own. I think that sometimes if I've hurt someone, it literally may not be intentionally going at them, but a reaction or like, all right, I'm triggered. So I'm going to go at you, and it's going to hurt you because I know how to hurt you because I know how to use my words. Man, I don't even have to use anybody, but I'm just going to use my words wisely. But it's still one of those things that we may not know that we're doing, that it's not like, if I have hurt someone, I apologize, but it's not like I'm not going out there saying because I'm hurting and I have been hurt, but I'm not going to intentionally go out there and cut your neck. I'm just not. It's not going to happen like that.
And my hurting of people was much different than mostly everybody. My hurting is not allowing anybody in to be close to me, to be with me.
Well, that might be happening.
And they start looking at themselves saying, emotionally, well, what's wrong? We're vibing good. We're having a good time. Why won't you allow me in that space? And that has hurt a lot of people, discouraged them, where they started to question themselves like, wait a minute, what's going on here?
That goes back to what Storm said, that healing within yourself. If you are not comfortable within yourself, you're not going to let other people in. So you have some healing to do on your own before you can open up. And the people that are around you, when you surround yourself with people that love and care about you, if it takes 1 year, 2 years, 6 years,
10 years,
8 years, 10 years, this is what I try to tell a lot of people about relationships. Everybody wants that great relationship, but like the gentleman said here, what doesn't kill you make you stronger. How strong do you think your relationship is going to be after being hurt for 10 years to let it go? What do you think that love is going to be like on the other side?
And also, I think it's important, again, I'm a communicator. I can't control how someone might do or what they might say. I can only control my reaction, because I'm not gonna lie, my emotions are one thing, my reactions are something else, because I can be pissed off and absolutely non-responsive because I don't want to make the situation and exacerbate the situation. But at the same time, if I'm at that place like you saying, D, because I'm like that, I let a person know ahead of time. Once I see that we're starting to be interested in that way, hey, I'm a very guarded person, I'm working on some things with me, please don't take it personal, because I'd rather tell you now so that you can have an informed decision of what you want to do going forward.
But Nikki mentioned something about healing, right? How do we even know that we need healing? There are people walking around thinking, oh, I got this. It's okay. I'm over that. But yet and still, every now and then, you be like, oh, I see some residue of what you've been through. How do people even know they're healed? If we're not in that realm, if we're not therapists, or we're not, how do you even know you're walking around hurt and still walking around with the baggage of what someone else did? Whether it's, we have some questions from the audience. When we're going to go to a break, and then we're going to come back to the questions from the audience. Is that what we're doing?
Remembering. Good. Without pain.
You gonna keep saying that, huh? Is that gonna be like this? Is that gonna be a hashtag, remembering without pain?
That's how you know you have healed.
Yeah, that's
or got to a place.
Yeah, got to a place.
But when we come back from commercial, we're gonna let our audience give us some questions or jump in and let's get some input.
And let's say shout out to Alvina Styles. Well, Alvina Styles has been with us since day one. The jewelry, the clothing, the accessories, Alvina Styles, shout out to you. Thank you so much for all you do. Let's go. Let go.
Hey.
Hey everybody, it's your girl, Shelly Shell Williams, producer of Single on a Saturday Night. Thank you so much for watching right here on Philly Cam. If you are single on a Saturday, Sunday, or single every night, text Word on the Street to 22828 for your chance to win our official Single on Every Night t-shirt. So text Word on the Street to 22828 for your chance to win a free Single on Every Night t-shirt. And you keep watching Single on a Saturday Night right here on Philly Cam. Listen, this is Single on a Saturday Night. We're going to have an amazing fashion show coming up with Philadelphia Models Guild, headed by our director herself, Mrs. Karen Montgomery. So, you know what? Sit back, because you know, fashion is explosive. So I need you to make sure it's exploding all over this TV screen, right? Let's go. Boom.
Hello, everyone, and thank you for having me here, Shelly. We appreciate it. We need to go. We don't have a set designer this afternoon, so we are doing a trunk show, and you get the most amazing clothing from a trunk. And we're going to start off. Tina, box fur on, high top. That's our model, Tina.
Yeah.
Next we have Samenia. The 70s were sparkling, and Samina is sparkling. This is Samina.
Woo! Sparkle.
Okay.
Look at that piece around her neck.
Yes, get it?
Yes, woo, honey.
Yes.
Philly fashion.
That's Miss Samina.
Your learning day.
Feel good being from the 70s, man.
Next we have Miss Marcy. Yes. Miss Marcy,
Marcy
is already 70s.
Yes.
And her black, and yes, her brown. Love the 70s. It. And her
black power,
eccentric
y'all
wig.
Black power.
Mm-hmm. I'm going back to the 70s.
I told you that.
She's so hot, she made the balloon bus.
That's Miss Marcy.
Popping off in here.
Miss Marcy got it private.
She's explosive.
Next week, she's in red.
Oh, yeah.
And she is ready for the 70s.
She said, wow.
Miss Sadina.
Yes. Get it.
Starting good trouble.
Get it.
That's good trouble.
That's good.
That red.
Miss yeah, the lady in yes, red.
The yes, lady in red. Yes, ma'am.
Gorgeous. Okay.
Next, we have one of your own. Miss Antoinette.
Antoinette.
Yeah.
Balenciaga black in the building.
And
woo, I love it. Yes.
Good.
She has arrived.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
She is 70 down.
Oh.
Woo. This is Miss Antoinette.
Go Nettie. Yes. Night.
Man, women get all the facts.
Her name is women Antoinette.
We need you to pose right here, Ruth. Look at that camera. Tell, that's right. Sing on a Saturday Night original right there. Why, why? Yes. Pose right with that camera. Woo. Yes. Woo!
Beautiful.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, look at the spot.
Next we have Miss Nikki. Miss Nikki, soft frills in her 70s yes, outfit. Woo. Black yes, and blue.
Got my name and
her
you ankle got your name,
brief.
Got your name on it. Yes.
It's Miss Nikki.
Miss Nikki is yeah,
woo!
No, she not. Miss Nikki has arrived.
This is Miss Nikki. Shining yeah, through the 70s.
Yeah. Yes. Shining through the 70s.
And our next 70s model is Miss Rhonda.
Black power.
Miss Rhonda has her sunglasses and her fringe bag. She's ready for the 70s.
There we go.
Yep. One, two.
Okay, Miss Rhonda.
That's Miss Rhonda.
Okay, Miss Rhonda.
Yes, we see you.
Not in trouble, Miss Rhonda.
We have two other scenes coming up, the Afrocentric and the evening wear. I'm not quite sure if
and they have to change for it. All right, we're going to cut. All right, that was Philadelphia Models Guild, and they're going to come back.
We are back. We are back for Single on Saturday night.
We Today's are back.
Hurt people, hurt people. And we have a statement or a question in the audience. We're going to go to Dr. Veronica Scott. Dr. Veronica Scott, hurt people, hurt people.
Well, I'm responding to two statements. Shelly asked a question, so I'm going to answer her question from my perspective. How do people realize whether or not they're hurting people or they're suffering some type of damage? They realize it when it comes to the self-realization that their relationships aren't working. They have to do self-analyzation to say, hey, what am I doing? If they're big enough to do that. Storm also made a statement about relationships and problems and things like that. What I wanted to say to his things, the Bible says love is to be able to love again. It takes patience. You have to be a patient person, and you have to have communication. When you start a relationship, it's very important that you discuss things. Not that your past should always be discussed, but if you had a trying situation, suffer some trauma, it needs to be discussed, and you should be comfortable.
Wait a minute,
how soon
does it need to be discussed?
Well,
I'm just saying.
At the appropriate time.
It's individual. Everything is individual, and that's what people need to realize. It's individual based. You know if your mate is, or your prospective mate is ready to handle what you have to say. If you can trust it. That's why it takes time. Whenever you think that it's the appropriate moment, then you explain. Or make become a challenge when they're, why are you doing this? Are you upset about this? Then you may need to have that conversation sooner than you would like. But it takes patience and an understanding mate to understand what you've been through. And to choose. That's why a person has an option. Do I want to deal with this? If they care enough about you or want to really learn, then they will have that patience. And that's what the Bible says. Love is patience.
Woo!
That was nice.
Dr. Scott. Up next is Dr. DJ Smooth. DJ Smooth.
All right, so quick question. Does it make a difference whether or not the person's intentions were to hurt you or not? When you consider how to cope and deal with your emotional reaction to it, and does that make a difference in how extreme your emotions are?
I would say yes.
If they can open up and say, I didn't really mean to hurt you like that. I responded with a trigger. Like, it's communication. So sometimes people don't mean to do certain things, like react in a negative way. But they got to have the communication, like Dr. Scott said.
They have to know how they made you feel, if that was the case. And that's the one thing that I said, I cannot control what another person's intention or what their action are. I can only control my response. So I respond by letting them know how they made me feel. If it felt intentional, I advise that. It felt like you meant to do that to me. Is that the case? Usually that acknowledgement comes, I'm sorry, no, I didn't mean it like that. And then that's when the conversation comes. I used to be like this, or I had to deal with this for so long, or this was what I was going through before, and that was how I reacted. Okay, I'm going to try to help you do it different, because that's not going to work for me. It's not going to work for us. Let's try to find a way to make it work for us.
But in reality, most of us, a lot of us, we've been in relationships where that conversation about intention did not happen. Let's think back. I ain't got to think that hard. But let's think back. Intentions doesn't always come up. It is a mature thing. And most of us are all up in our feelings most of the time. So we're not thinking about intention. We just thinking about, you did that to me. period, and we haven't gone on. So we're going back to the maturity of it. It doesn't happen often. That's why a lot of relationships don't work, because they still haven't matured enough to say, let me think about it. Maybe you didn't mean it that way. But that takes a mature, healed individual, and not a lot of us are all totally healed. We all still walking around with a big old butt of baggage.
Wait a minute.
That's why we're here talking about it, so we can have some people work and sift through that baggage and get rid of some things they don't need.
And wait a minute. And some of us, we all assume that we all in this kumbaya situation. You know, you hurt me. Well, you didn't mean it. I hurt you. Well, why did you do that? Because you hurt me. Are you sorry? No, I'm not sorry. You want me to stop hurting you? You stop hurting me. So now let's start
having.
Isn't
that tit for tat?
But let's start having that conversation. It's not always about the person being hurt. There's also some responsibility, because sometimes people do things that hurt you. So I don't want you to think every time that you're triggered or you're hurt that you don't have a defense mechanism. But again, it's the beginning of the conversation. You hurt me, I hurt you, you hurt me. Somebody going to have to stop this cycle. Yeah.
But I hear this conversation. Got to have a conversation. Got to have a conversation. Here's what you got to. Women got to talk to men about men. But it got to be a man that's going to tell you the truth about yourself and about men. Guys, we got to talk. We can't talk to our homies about a woman. We got to have a woman that's close to us that will say, Stormy, let me tell you the truth about you.
Exactly.
Let me tell you the truth about women. But here's the part that most people can't get. You might get a person you can talk to about that, but it cannot be somebody that is attracted to you.
Facts. So I want you to say that again. Say that again. Say that loud and proud. Say that one more time. Say that one more time. Go ahead. Make that plain.
You gotta have a woman or a man
facts.
That will tell you the truth about you
and
the truth about their gender.
Mm-hmm.
But that person cannot be sexually attracted.
Come on, man. You better stop talking that.
You got to say that loud and
that's
proud.
Logic.
How many people, Nikki, can establish a person like that that's that genuine, that will do that? And that's where we got to get to that point. And then at that point, a whole different type of healing will start happening.
All right, so we got an audience. We got Dr. C. Nicole in the building. Hey.
Thank you so much for, I'm glad that I was able to participate and even come out. So this is a wonderful event. I look forward to the move and where you're going to have it at next. And I just want to say, we also have to take accountability for our own relationships and what we are going to tolerate. You know, what our standards are and stick by it. Because sometimes we give too much opportunity and too much of a chance. It's like, wait a minute. Whether you meant to do that or not, yes, I'm going to say, I don't want to deal with this. You know what I mean? Like, I'm going to say, okay, some people, you push forward and you say, okay, well, maybe we can work through this. But sometimes we know we can't work through it. Sometimes we know the person is immature. We know what we see. We've seen it. So we have to be the strong ones within ourselves to just be like, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and bow out gracefully.
I'm good on
it's
this
okay.
one. Thank you. I'm good on that one.
All right, Slick the King in the building. Yes, off the extraordinaire.
All right. Well, one of the things I wanted to go back to is something that you said, Shelly. You said when we're in our feelings. That's something that people need to think a little bit about a little bit more, because we're talking about hurt people. We all kind of been hurt in some way or another.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of times in relationships, we just want to concentrate on, well, this one did this to me in the past and I'm not accepting this. And that person that you're in a relationship with, they've been hurt in the past too. So a lot of times in 2022, the age of social media, microwave relationships, we want everything fast. We want it to come perfect. It's not going to come like that. You got to be willing to fall in love with the person over and over and over again. It's going to be hurt in the relationship. It's going to be hurt in childhood. But you got to know that it's a beating heart in your partner just like it is in you. So it's a whole lot of understanding that I don't see in the dating scene. We got to understand that we all come with something. And just like you want somebody to understand you, you got to understand them.
The art of courting is missing.
We better have respect in every
relationship.
Have respect for each other.
So, man, we've been getting to some deep things, certain expressions from men and women. But when we come back from commercial,
this is the end of our show.
It went quick, baby.
We can't. We back. We live, man.
Well,
we in person.
Don't have it. What's the next week's
Am
show?
Am I enough to be enough? Are you enough to be enough?
Let's go. Ooh.
On Saturday night, I'm Mr. Goodnight, Shelly Shell, Chatty Hattie, Stormy's in the
big homie Stormy Weathers.
Let's go. Nikki, and we got Roberto. We'll be right back. Show two.